The British pound sees a second session of sell-off, seeing it move from earlier on Friday from 138, actually north of 138, all the way down today to the mid-136 handle, getting back to 137 sort of by the end of the session, but clearly some profit-taking, clearly some position squaring ahead of key events this week, those events being the FOMC meeting on Wednesday, followed by the Bank of England meeting on Thursday, culminating on Friday with the U.S. jobs report. But taking a step back, we were off on year-to-date lows when this rally began back in October, early October. We saw it go from the 128 handle all the way up to 138 plus, and then now we're back down around 137. So only a modest pushback, but clearly a position squaring or profit taking ahead of key events. What if the market is overpriced? What if something comes out of left field? There looks to be maybe some buying opportunities if the dollar gets a real big bid after FOMC. That could affect the pound as well. So a lot of things moving there, but clearly the pound is in the direction of moving higher, given the fact that the hawkish stance that the Bank of England has been taking and has been talking about in the news, and that has taken us up to these levels. A modest pullback ahead of a big event, not the strangest thing I've ever seen. So at this point, keep an eye there, but clearly we have to get through the Fed meeting first on Wednesday, then followed by the Bank of England meeting on Thursday. Now, what does this all mean for volatility? Well, if you check out that CVOL index over at cmegroup.com, event risk tends to pump up volatility, and that's exactly what we're seeing, although it is trading close to steady after the big sell-off and rally. So keep an eye on that volatility level. As we enter into events, we tend to see volatility go higher than post-event. We see things head south pretty quickly. It'll be interesting to see what happens in this scenario, given the line of central bank meetings this week. Lastly, let's look at positioning. What are speculators doing in the pound? Well, they're the most long they've been since July. So clearly some bullish sentiment there that the pound will rally. It'll be interesting to see what happens again after the Fed meeting. If a rallying dollar pulls the pound lower, will that allow speculators an opportunity to step back in and buy on the lows? Likewise, after the event of the Bank of England meeting, what will the culmination be there? Will speculators look to get out and play another day? But ultimately, we have to get through these events. We have to see what happens with volatility. And obviously, speculators are a big driving force in these markets. So day two of a modest sell-off after the recent highs north of 138, ahead of the FOMC meeting on Wednesday and Bank of England meeting on Thursday.